Hey, what's up, guys? Star Brother here. Welcome back to part two of the Executor class in-depth analysis. And of course, I am not alone on camera today. I have T-Rex 2248.
Hello.
Who in my next video will have a special announcement for the end of the video, because he'll also be appearing in the next video of the in-depth analysis of the Constitution class. So be ready for that. All right, now that we got all the pleasuries out of the way, let's get back to what we were talking about last episode. We left off with the fate of the Lusankia. Unfortunately, unlike her sister ship, the Guardian, who's also serving the New Republic, she was destroyed. During the Yuuzhan Vong War, in one of the initial battles, she was destroyed because they underestimated the Yuuzhan Vong. So, unfortunately, the Lusankia was destroyed in combat. Now, the final one we're going to talk about today, before me and T-Rex get into our overall opinions of the ship, is the Executor, the most famous Executor-class superstar destroyer, and personal flagship of the one, the only, Darth Vader. The Executor class was, as of itself, the Lusankia were the first two Executor classes to be commissioned. Of course, Lusankia was put in Coruscant as the Emperor's personal evacuation, and Darth Vader was given the Executor. Unfortunately, the Executor would also meet a similar fate to the Lusankia. The Executor would be destroyed at the Battle of Endor by a rogue A-Wing that lost control of its ship and crashed into its bridge. Alright, so. Now that we got all the doom and gloom out of the way, it's time to go to possibly one of you guys' favorite parts of the video, the personal opinions of the ship. T-Rex, do you want to go first?
Yeah.
Okay. So, all my overall opinions. I love this ship. This ship is by far one of my favorite Star Wars ships. It's big, it's bulky, it has a lot of firepower, and there's a good balance between capital ship destruction and point defense anti-starfighter capabilities. The question was popped up, and one of the questions I know you're going to ask is, would I pick this as my personal flagship? Yes, I would. While yes, there are bigger ships like the Eclipse-class Star Destroyer that I will be doing an in-depth analysis of later on. Yes, there are bigger ships in the Star Wars universe. However, with me saying that, the Executor class has a lot more firepower than the Eclipse would. And to me, it's just the Executor brings a sign of fear to any star system you're in. I mean, if I personally looked up at the sky and saw a bulking 9-kilometer Executor class Star Destroyer followed by dozens of smaller Imperial class Star Destroyers, any hope of rebelling against the Empire then is, come on, almost gone. I mean, I'm not going to go up against that massive of a ship. And if you're an Imperial Admiral, or heaven forbid a Grand Admiral, you're going to want that kind of intimidation on your side. And it's been often called, the Executor class has been often called, to quote Space Doc, the epitome of the Tarkin Doctrine. Which the Tarkin Doctrine is big, bulky ships that basically extract fear. They walk up to you and they're just like, if you fire, we're going to fire everything we got back at you. Alright, T-Rex, your overall opinions of the ship.
I mean, it's a good ship to have, but I wouldn't pick it as my main flagship.
Now, why is that?
Too big.
Really? So you would be more like the Rebellion, hit-and-run tactics?
No, I would prefer a little bit of a smaller ship.
Well, the Executor class is 9 kilometers long. And, what are some overall things that you would change about the Executor?
I'll keep the firepower. I'll just make it a couple kilometers smaller because it's way too big.
Well, you think about the spoilers for Last Jedi. You think about the supremacy on supremacy.
Just for this.
I'm not spoiling.
I
mean, it's similar to it's similar to how the supremacy is work. I mean, it's 60 kilometers long. I mean, heck, I mean, it takes like almost like five of these things of the executives just to even match it. So I can see the size comparison, and I'm gonna have to disagree with you. I mean, I think a size things like that, but I think a size thing. It goes along the line with what the Tarkin Doctrine wanted in a ship. A big ship that could be used fear. It instills fear in anyone who hopes to rebel.
Well, I know, but I mean, it's way too easy to get lost in.
Yeah, some stormtroopers say it takes 3 days to get from one end to the other.
Oh, wow.
So, well, that's all we have time for today in today's in-depth analysis. Here's the thing. If you want debates like this, like debates where we debate something, sorry. Leave that on the comment if you want a debate on, and a more in-depth debate on the Executor class.
And for the video after the next video, which is
the Constitution.
After the Constitution, leave down in the comment what sci-fi show you want us to do next.
All right, like always, great to have you. Leave a like and subscribe down below. 84 comments the last I checked. And that's great. We're only about 16 away from 100. 100, 3 digits.
If we get 100 likes on this video and we do both Death Stars.
Yes. That's actually the next thing I'm going to point out. Big news, guys. The Death Star is our next big thing.
If we get 100 likes, we'll do it.
Well, if we get 100 likes, we'll do the Death Star 2. But I was originally planning on doing the Death Star 1.
Okay.
The Death Star 1 will be the next big Star Wars in-depth analysis. Now, as you can see, now the way we're going to do this is that I'm going to do regular ships for the Star Trek in-depth analysis. But for Star Wars, we're going to do big, big things like the Galaxy Gun and Star Killer. So yeah. Leave a like down below. Leave a comment on what ship you want me to do next. And right, like I said, next video, Constitution. Special analysis about, can't think of the words. Special announcement for this one. All right, guys. This is Star Brother and T-Rex signing out. Have a great day.